questions at the end of class, okay? All right. We've been talking about rockets this week. And hold on. All right. We've been talking about rockets this week. On Monday, we drew a rocket and we learned about the parts. We have our body and our nose cone and the fins. And I saw that some of you did rocket boosters as well. But this is what we're going to talk about today. In a real rocket, it burns fuel and it produces a gas, which is produces the thrust to make it go into the air. So we are going to look at some different ways to make thrust for a rocket, okay? Now I know some of you have stuff you wanna share. I want you to hold on till the end, okay? And I will answer all your questions, okay? All right, so here we go. Hold on. All right, to start, we're going to look at some air rockets. So we can produce thrust with air. And if you came to the, if you watched the video on Tuesday, which I see a lot of you did, I showed you how to make a straw rocket. Now this one requires two different size straws, which is hard to find. I had to order these straws because I didn't have them either. But if that's something that you want to do, this sheet is on my Clever page that you can print out and you can make your own straw rocket. And to do it, you can blow it with air. And that provides the thrust to do this. Now we've also got some big straw rocket launchers. And I've made a, I have a plastic straw here and I put some clay on top. And I have a big straw rocket launcher. And to do this, I can place it right here and I can launch it. So I've made a quick video to show you a little bit of launching straw rockets because I can't do it in class because I can't show you. So hold on and I'm going to show you a video of me launching straw rockets. So I'll be right back. All right, straw and a little piece of putty. So I'm going to block off the top of my straw and I'm going, because I want the air to push it off and I don't want it to go right through. So now I have a rocket shape and I'm going to be a rocket launcher here, okay? A straw rocket launcher. So on here, it shows me the different degrees. So this is 90 degrees, that's gonna be straight up. 0 degrees is going to be just straight ahead. I'm going to try at a 45 degree angle. So I'm going to place my straw on the rocket launcher, make sure that there's no holes. And how this works is I have a tube right here that I can lift up and let it drop. Okay, so over here are different measurements. These are centimeters of how high I'm going to lift it. So this is 0 centimeters. If I lift it to, let's say 10 centimeters and drop it, we're going to see, hopefully I can show you this, how far it goes. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Okay, so that didn't go very far. What if I pull it up to 20 centimeters? My straw back on here, sorry, it's difficult with one hand. And I'm going to pull it up to 20 centimeters. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, it went quite a bit farther. Let's see what happens if I can bring it, let's see how high it goes. Ooh, goes up to 46 centimeters. Are you ready? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, that went
a lot farther. There's more pressure being placed on it to launch the rocket. Okay, this is a straw rocket launcher, so it's a
All right, so if you were here last year with me, you might have been able to launch a straw rocket. And hopefully next year we'll be doing the same thing. But something you can do at home, because we don't really have rocket launchers at home, is you can use a water bottle. Inside here is going to be air, right? You can use a 2-liter bottle, like a soda bottle, or even a bottle that you might have around the kitchen once it's empty. I don't want to use this one yet because there's still stuff in it. But to make a rocket, I can just wrap a piece of paper around the edge of my whatever has the air in it, or I could use the cap, would be a lot easier. And then I want to secure an end. So all I did was taped it up. I cut it a little shorter so it's not so long, and I made a point because I want to make sure that there's no air that comes out. Then I can place it on here and I can release the air and it can launch. And you can do that with a soda bottle or any kind of plastic bottle as well. All right. So that is using air as our thrust. Another thing we can do is use a rubber band. Now a rubber band, if I pull it and I let it go, it's going to snap back together, right? So I have a little finger rocket here. I will sail it through the air. But something that you can do at home is you can get 2 plastic cups and a couple rubber bands, okay? And you can test this out. You can also make one of those out of a pool noodle. There's lots of tutorials online. But all I'm gonna do is take 1 rubber band, you can get help from your parents, and put it around. And I'm going to put another one, make an X on the top, and I can take a 3rd rubber band to hold them in place, okay? So they're pretty secure. Now, this is going to be my rocket. I'm gonna take another cup and place it upside down. Now again, this is really difficult to show you on a computer, but to launch, this is the one with the rubber band, I can place it on top, and I can let it go and it's going to launch because those rubber bands are going to stretch and then they're going to go back to where they were. So they're going to force my rocket up and that's going to create the thrust for this rocket. So that's something simple you can do. You can try different size cups with rubber bands. All right. Now, a real rocket has a, the fuel is going to be so powerful to lift it off. So I did one more experiment, and this one you should not do at home unless you have a parent with you. But I used some Alka-Seltzer tabs and something that we don't have anymore at all around home, which is a little film canister. We used to take pictures with a roll of film and put it in our camera, and you'd have them developed. These are really hard to find right now. So I did an experiment. I'm going to show you a little video of it. And I put some water and some Alka-Seltzer tabs in here because the Alka-Seltzer, when it mixes with water, is going to create carbon dioxide and it's going to build up some pressure in here and you'll see a little rocket explode, okay? So I'm going to share my screen one more time with a little experiment. I'll be right back.
Hi, boys and girls. Today, I'm going to show you an experiment, and we're going to see if we can make some film canisters explode or act like a rocket. So we're going to build up some pressure. I've got some Alka-Seltzer tablets, and we're going to add water to them. So let me show you what we're going to do. All right, I have 3 different film canisters. On one, I've got 1/4 of an Alka-Seltzer tablet. On the next one, I have 1/2. And on the 3rd one, I have a full. So we are going to see if those can explode. So first, I'm going to add some water to each of these, and we will do them one at a time. All right. I'm going to flip in the quarter. I'm going to flip it over, and we're going to see what happens. We'll wait and find out. All right, I'm a little scared to try the bigger ones. Okay, here we're going to try half of a tablet.
Be back so maybe we can see all of it.
All right, and the third one is an entire tablet. Watch out. All right.
All right. Did you guys see how those exploded? Pretty cool. Now, don't try that at home without an adult, but those are some fun little experiments that you could try. Ooh, I see a rubber band rocket already. Did you notice that that first one with only a little tab flew really high into the sky, but it took a lot longer? And the one with a full tablet went a lot quicker, but it didn't go nearly as high. So something to think about and why that would happen. But that is kind of like a real rocket where it builds up that pressure until it can't take anymore. And then the rocket is going to blast into the air. So since today is our last day together, I just wanted to leave some time for us to share our stuff and share whatever we wanted. I'm so glad you guys have come to my class this year. And I'm so glad that I get to see you even though you're not at school. I hope to see a lot of your faces next year back in the building, hopefully, when it's safe and we're all ready. And I wish you all a very wonderful summer, and I miss you all.